Henri Daumier is an artist who at this time was suspected of subversive activities. And this is really, really common. After all, the artists are creating very uncomfortable circumstances for the society as well as for the ruling elite. Now, Daumier was a defender of the working class, mercilessly satirizing the upper classes. He also had an in-depth knowledge of the Parisian Revolt of 1830 and the Revolution of 1848, imbuing his work with a sense of power and truth, a sense of credibility because he was there, he took part, and therefore his work is taken more seriously. The piece we're looking at is Rue Transnonain, and the title refers to a street where a sniper killed a civil servant. Because the shot came from a working-class apartment building, the civil guard stormed and slaughtered the inhabitants. Here, what we see is the terrible aftermath rather than the scene at its height. The image is rough and spontaneous, using contemporary facts as a basis for illustration rather than using the classical allegory that we might otherwise see. He's not changing this into mythology. He's not changing this into a biblical form. Instead, he's giving us raw fact and raw truth. So let's look at the work. What you're going to see here is innocent people who have been slaughtered, and more to the point, an entire family. And we get a sense of the story from the image. Let's start with the bed. We have what appears to be a cut in the bed, possibly someone bayoneted while they were asleep, probably the father from the looks of it. Beneath him, his daughter bayoneted in the head. You can get that sense of the father in a last desperate attempt to save his daughter, standing up and fighting whatever soldiers are coming in at the time. The wife over here was probably hacked down earlier. Maybe she was awake at the time. Maybe any number of things. And the elderly man, probably a grandfather to the child, again, killed, likely bayoneted. And this whole thing happening in a very specific space. He doesn't pick the kitchen or the living room. He picks the space where you are safest, the bedroom. I mean, think about it. When you're a kid, you have that idea that if I just cover myself with the blanket, nothing can hurt me. It's always a safe space, right? It's where you can relax. It's where you can find rest. And yet that is where he has set the slaughter. This is all to get across the idea of how unfair this slaughter was. After all, one sniper takes a shot. You don't kill an entire building worth of working class people. And nothing here is about class. It doesn't scream working class. These are average Parisians that are being depicted. What it does is it creates a situation where when you look at it, you could imagine that this would be your family. You get a sense of deep injustice, something that goes far deeper than any mythological or biblical narrative that could be applied to a similar scene. Now, there's one other thing he does. He puts this out as a lithograph, which allows him to put out multiple copies, thousands of copies, very, very quickly. And that's important with images like this. You want to develop that injustice, and you want as many people to see it as possible.